Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Human Nutrition. In that we are studying topic assimilation of nutrients. Now when I say assimilation, it simply means accumulation of nutrients or just putting together all the nutrients. What's that? Let's study about it today. Assimilation of nutrients. Now once the process of digestion begins, and the process of digestion basically breaks down all the complex molecules into simpler compounds. Once that is done, the process of assimilation starts. Now assimilation could be simply said as resynthesizing or just putting back together all those molecules to form a bigger molecule which your body is going to use, like formation of proteins or polypeptides, formation of carbohydrates, lipids. Now whenever assimilation takes place, assimilation makes sure that all your fat molecules which are extra are stored inside liver. All your amino acids which were not used or not required by your diet or not needed by your body at this point of time has to be stored somewhere. And certain molecules like carbon dioxide which has to be removed, which can never be kept inside your body. Also the excess of glucose or the end product of carbohydrate metabolism, which is glucose, a simple sugar. Now that reaches the liver by hepatic portal vein. And inside liver, what happens is this excess of glucose is converted into glycogen. So in totality, we can say assimilation looks forward of food materials by keeping them when they are not required, or basically simply storing them when they are not required and then reuse them whenever they will be required down later. It is an anabolic process. So anabolic means addition process by which absorbed nutrients enter into your cell and are involved later for use. Assimilation of nutrients. It means taking care of those nutrients which the body doesn't need right now, but it will eventually use it later on. Basically trying to restore those nutrients in body. It could be fats in the case of fatty cells, or glucose, or amino acids for that matter. Now assimilation of nutrients is basically an anabolic process by which you absorb nutrients enter into cell, and once they enter, they are involved in the metabolic process further. That is to resynthesize complex molecules like proteins, it could be lipids or fats or carbohydrates. Now the end product of carbohydrate breakdown is basically glucose, a simple sugar, which reaches liver via hepatic portal vein. And once it reaches there, in liver, excess of glucose is basically converted into glycogen. The amino acid that actually reach the liver via hepatic portal veins, where surplus amino acids gets deaminated. Now, when I say deaminated, it means eventually breakdown or destruction. The amino acids which were eventually not required as a source of energy by you on that particular day. Now, separated amino acids are also converted into urea form with combining with CO2, and these are secreted or removed out from your body in the form of urine. Some fats are stored in the liver and your bone, even your adipose tissues. Now, adipose tissues could be your thighs, buttocks, all those regions. Now, as we were studying that some fats are stored inside the liver. Now, fats which are stored inside liver, those could be your saturated fatty acids, unsaturated fatty acids, any one of those. Also, adipose tissues store extra amount of fats. We all know that 1 gram or 1 tablespoon of any fats would eventually give you 9 calories. That's a huge amount. Now, these fats sometimes enter in the composition of your cell organelles. Now, when I say cell organelles, remember phospholipid bilayer? Now, those phospholipid bilayers are the molecules that are present inside the cell. They basically have a head structure as well as a tail that allow the entry and exit of the molecules. They could be hydrophilic, hydrophobic, and those are made up of fat molecules or globules. Now, some fat molecules are also used as a source of fuel. If eating fats gives you 9 kilocalories, then fats could be said as the one of the sources of energy or one molecule which can give you a tremendous amount of energy. So basically, during assimilation, what is done is that where fats have to be stored, this is looked forward. Whereas your proteins are never stored, whatever proteins are required for bodybuilding are eventually used. And finally, they undergo deamination or they have to be removed out in the form of urea from the urine. And carbohydrates are basically stored by the process of gluconeogenesis. So students, in this part of the chapter, we came across assimilation of nutrients. I hope you are very clear with this concept. Thank you.